So for the second part of our lecture this week on cinematography, now I want to provide four examples from fight scenes. What I want to do is to compare and contrast these clips to see how DPs, the directors of photography, would be able to convey a multitude of ideas and emotion in each of these clips. The first clip is from a movie called Born Identity, and in this movie, and specifically in that scene, the director wants to pass a feeling of confusion and anxiety. So you have odd angles, rapid editing, but also breaking of the 180 degree rules. The sort of framings that you are not really kind of certain what is going to happen. Reaction shots in all these clips that I want to show are also an example of what the director wanted. So you see usually a woman in this in these fight scenes. So in this time, the uncertainty and being worried is something that you can see in her facial expression, and you're going to see is that kind of feeling present in the way that the scene is shot.
Open that. Tell me what's inside.
So you see quick shots and like the number of upside down even images. And that's actually not a correct point of view. You don't see the word upside down in that situation. But you see the rapid editing, just as like the facial expressions of the observer, the witness to the fight is suggesting. And there are constant breaking of 180 degree rules, and in a way it's just this a kind of fight that we don't know the outcome.
That would be the exact opposite of the next clip from The Only God Forbids, where the fight is more choreographed. Rather than creating a sense of anxiety, it is the static of the fight that matters in the next clip. So that's why the scene is arranged in a very calm ways. We don't have rapid editings, not too many close-ups or odd angles or close framings. As the facial expressions of the one who witnessed the fight suggest, this is not supposed to be surprising or anxious. As I said, this is not really about a confusion like the previous clip, but what matters is the aesthetic of the fight. So, unlike the first scene, you saw how everything was calm and at the same time choreographed and arranged. So it was not really giving us any sense of anxiety, but more a sense of a kind of aesthetic quality. The third scene that I want to show is from Martin Scorsese's movie Raging Bull. And pay attention, in the following clip, the director wants to pass the mood of brutality, something that we don't want to watch, and you see that actually in the reaction shots of the woman who's looking at this scene. So unlike the first two clips, in this one, it's just the brutality of the fight that matters, and actually the character that we identify with is open up to being beaten. So it's a masterpiece of editing, but at the same time there are a number of interesting cinematographic devices used. Different film stocks for that scene. The scene is very bright, but at the same time that the facial expressions were captured. They also used flames around the camera to make certain parts of the film bright, and it seems that other parts of the image were burned. And I think you know both the boys.
Nobody knows. No man can endure this moment. The fight is stopped on the signal. to Frankie Sakora. Row after row after row from the ring. The crowd is standing and cheering as he just cannonated.
So I looked at the cinematography. It's actually, as I said, certain parts of the image is flat. It's just, you see, it's very foggy or it's just totally black. But certain, every details on the face is visible, a clear sort of focus with a strong light on it. Also, you see that the use of rapid editing with extreme close-ups, all these things to just, if you're facing everything, like the whole problem, the whole brutality, and use of slow motion and rapid editing together in a very, very kind of smooth way. All these things kind of contributed in making this interesting transition. The last clip that I want to show is from Rocky IV, and that's a more standard fight scene. In this, or rather than the previous one, that you didn't want to be there, you didn't want that happen, that when I said that it was about the brutality of the fight. Here, the fight is actually very heroic.
We kind of want to be there, as the Sylvester Stallone character is representing the United States of America. There is a feeling of empathy present in that scene, and the fight is actually glorified, I would say. And in terms of the observers, you see kids, for example, watching this game on TV, and they imitate the action. They're very excited about the game.
So in terms of the techniques, little low or high angles, very interesting actually, shots. The use of a Steadicam inside the ring at that time was revolutionary. You usually see not many close-ups, usually see sort of medium close-ups, two characters in the frame. The scene doesn't confuse you, doesn't really cross the 180 degree rules, so it's a more kind of using a more standard like sport cinematography, right angle to this, just a little slight low angle shot.
Rocky Balboa is in serious trouble. They might have to stop this one before somebody gets killed.
Usually we have the two characters just avoiding confusion in the fight.
Rocky's hurt. He walked the sleeping giant and now he's picking up his right hand from Rocky. Sends Rocky Balboa 15 feet across the ring. And the champ is down. Drago continuing to punish Rocky Balboa. He just will not let him out of that corner. Rocky Balboa is just trying to get through this first round.
Like a rag doll.
A tough first 3 minutes for Rocky Balboa. He's not only fighting what appears to.
In this scene that I'm showing, look at actually that thing about the kids watching it on TV, how it just adds to that excitement. That quick image adds to that feeling. The kids are trying to empathize with the fact.
Cheers now for Rocky Balboa. win over. That was once a hostile crowd.
Yeah. So, like you see, it's just an example of not too rapid editing, not too slow like the first two, and not too odd like the third one. It's more standard, and it just adds to the heroic aspect of the fight. So you see four different fight scenes, but they all have passing different moods, and it's just because of one reason that they pass different mood to us is just this, how the cinematographer worked and what devices he employed. Did he break the 180 degree rules, like the first one, to create a confused sort of space, or avoiding the 180 degree rules in this one, because the director didn't want to confuse us, rather than wants to us to empathize with the characters with his heroic stand against the Soviet opponent. So these are the things, these sort of comparisons that I want you to put in your screening quizzes.
So the movie that you're going to watch this week for the screening quiz is Rashomon by Akira Kurosawa, maybe the most well-known Japanese filmmaker internationally. So the same incident is shown from the perspectives of different characters, I just want you to pay attention to how each account is presented, and in a way choose one and say how it's different from the other ones, how the cinematography is trying to pass on the perspective of one character. So this movie was made in 1950 in Japan, and it has a medieval setting, and at that time actually a number of filmmakers were using medieval setting to pass certain kinds of censorships at that time. After the occupation of Japan, filmmakers were not able to directly criticize American troops. So to refer to the national trauma that they experienced, such as the nuclear attack at Nagasaki, they were using medieval settings. And so in this film, you see indirect references to like polluted water that they get stomachic by drinking it. So it seems that certain strange things are happening that they couldn't explain. The debris of the building, the light that comes from the sky. So all these things were some sort of a commentary on the kind of what Japan experienced during the World War II. So, again, pay attention to the cinematography. There are also an interesting acting of Toshiro Mifune, who became famous since then. But pay attention to what sort of cinematographic devices were used. And again, it's a movie about our prejudices, how we kind of always carry some sort of judgment in a way we remember incidents. So in actually law studies, there is a term known as Rashomon effects, when those who witness the acts were giving contradictory statements. So now we have different perspectives of people who were involved in the incident. How each perspective is different in a way that it is photographed.